Joining me now to talk about the mayor's legal and apparent behavioral issues are criminal defense attorney Janet Johnson and HLN contributor, psychotherapist Dr. Tiffany Davis-Henry. Thank you both for being here with me. Janet, I want to start with you because if the city council does approve this settlement, the mayor resigns, walks away, he still faces a boatload of legal problems, right?
Right. Well, in terms of this settlement, this is his aide, the only person who sued him, the city, and this is all under wraps. But the understanding is that the government will pay for all or most or some of his legal fees as it goes to his aide and also some of the settlement fees. So the only person who's suing him right now, this would encompass that lawsuit. And she may be the only person with damages. It was part of her job. She actually probably suffered on the job because of this, or at least Gloria Allred, her lawyer, will say that. These other women, you know, where there's smoke, there's fire. But to some extent, one woman who just got touched on the behind, I'm not saying that that's not a very traumatic thing for her, but her damages may not be significant. So he may not be on the hook for a lot more money than what comes of this one lawsuit.
But Janet, why in the world would his legal fees be paid by taxpayers? That seems infuriating.
Right. And that's the law of California and a lot of other places. But there's a very specific law in California that says that if it arises during his work as the mayor, which this would, this one person would, because she was his aide, then it's covered. Now, they can go back and try to indemnify or get back some of the costs from him. But the law in California actually covers it. So it does seem
the
bad.
Law is the law. Let me bring in Dr. Tiff, because that's the legal side. There's also a behavioral side here. You know, he said he went to rehab for his behavior issues. That seems to be a pretty common thing for people in the public eye to say, to sort of keep everyone quiet.
Yeah.
Okay, I got a problem. I'm going to go away for a little bit to a rehab facility.
And
he left her early.
Which rehab facility do you know, Lynn, is only 2 weeks and addresses these types of issues? This is something that is longstanding. It's obviously chronic. It's something that, you know, he's got a problem with. 2 weeks is not going to cut it. For most people, therapy, 2 weeks doesn't cut it. It's over the long haul that you start to see some positive changes. Now, he has been accused by 18 different women, but there were only 3 that actually worked for him, you know? So, and that's why the sexual harassment claim is a little tricky. He also was doing a lot more flirting with the women that weren't working with him than he was really offending, asking people out on a date, clutching their hand, and you know, and saying things that were a little creepy, but I don't know if it actually went in the face of sexual harassment. He definitely doesn't have swag. He doesn't know how to pick up women in an appropriate way.
He hasn't got the
maybe those are the classes he should have been taking for 2 weeks.
Exactly. How about Smith Moves 101, Bob?
Yeah,
that probably served him a little bit.
Sometimes it must work, Dr. Tiff. I mean, obviously, he's been reinforced. His behavior has been reinforced.
Well, but see, that's the thing.
As evidenced by what? No one else has come forward?
Everybody seems to be creeped out by it that's complaining. So it's almost like this is something that he's continuously seeking,
right,
even after being rejected.
You know,
and
actually,
some of the women say they've rejected his advances.
And that's why there's a part of me that feels a little sorry for him, because I feel like this is a guy who's lonely, who wants a date, who wants to pick up ladies, and is using whatever tactic he knows, but what's the problem is those tactics don't work and actually are offensive to women. And
but
he's
had
to learn
fiance,
how to better
Dr.
respect
Tiff.
Women.
So,
Janet's
saying he had a fiance.
Had or has?
Had. She left after all of this went down, so there's a good point.
Good girl.
Good girl. Okay, Janet, you know, if this is a behavioral issue, is that come into play? Even though it's a law in California that the taxpayers would pick up the legal fees, does that come into play if this is more of a behavioral issue, if this has to do with him, not that he falls into some sort of situation because he's the mayor?
Well, you know, actually, I was thinking when you said that, Lynn, it could actually be part of a defense, and he might be able to say he has some sort of disability based on a mental illness, and that, in fact, the lawyer in me is saying, in fact, you can't fire him, you can't get rid of him, you can't oust him based on a mental disability. That's why the treatment is probably something that's going to not just help his behavior, but it might help his legal battle to say, I was suffering from depression. I do have a history of never doing anything like this, and all of a sudden, just like his supporters are saying,
women
I'm doing this.
Out of
all
nowhere.
At the same time. All right, Dr. Tiff, Janet, you guys, thanks for being with
me.
You have a good weekend. All right, well, hey, George.